Today, we're talking about the great bird of the galaxy, Star Trek creator Gene Roddenberry. Even if you've never seen one episode of Star Trek, you know what Star Trek is. Today on the show, we're reviewing Logan, plus bonus review of the comic Old Man Logan that is slightly based off...
So tell me about Wolverine the Logan. I loved it.
So Logan. Logan is definitely the best Wolverine movie that Fox has made. By far and away. By far and away. And it's definitely much better than most of the X-Men films, even though I kind of count most of the X-Men films as Wolverine films because he's pretty much always the main character. It's never really been about the X-Men. It's always been about Wolverine, specifically Hugh Jackman as Wolverine, because I will say Hugh Jackman has done such an amazing job as this character. He has just knocked it out of the park. I have so much respect for him for like how he has respected the character of Logan and taken it seriously and how like ripped he's gotten over the years. Like, oh my God.
So what was the Logan movie about?
Okay. So the Logan movie is set years in the future. Logan is older now. Professor X is older now. Some bad shit has gone down. The X-Men are no longer a thing, apparently.
Is this in continuity with all the other X-Men movies?
I mean, I guess so, yeah.
So all the X-Men are dead?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, most of them. And the mutants aren't being born anymore. There's no more mutants being born. And it's kind of like this, I'm not gonna say post-apocalyptic, but it's like they live in this kind of dystopian kind of society now.
What's that mean?
Dystopian is where like things haven't fallen through, it just sucks. You know, like apocalyptic, like everything's fallen apart. Dystopian, things haven't fallen apart, they're just not like awesome. Just kind of sucks.
How's that different than what we have?
Well, no, we're definitely entering a dystopian future right now. Yeah, I mean, we're on our way.
Oh.
Yeah, which could turn into an apocalypse. I don't know, you know, I mean, anything could happen. Everything's up for grabs right now. So it's wild times. Embrace the chaos. So Logan is now an Uber driver of the future. He drives around in a limo. He's got a limo that he drives around. He picks all these assholes up and he tries to get... You know, tries to take care of Professor X with Caliban. Caliban is also hanging out. He used to be a Morlock.
Is Caliban a real character?
He is a real character. He's
what
absolutely.
Does he do?
He was a Morlock. He was a part of the Morlocks who lived underground in New York and like was a part of that whole thing.
What did the Morlocks do?
Well, the Morlocks were all the kind of ugly, like homeless mutants that weren't like sexy and awesome that Professor X just kind of let fall through the cracks. we can't save everybody. And if you're a rich dude, you're gonna find the best, hottest mutants. And he did. And the Morlocks are like the not hot, awesome mutants that live underground, kind of as hobos.
So the people that have like three arms and green, weird, ugly skin.
Yes, a lot of those. Yeah.
Slime people.
Slime people, yeah.
Yeah, people that would get the X-Mansion all slimy.
Yeah, yeah, a few of those. Yeah, they're down there.
What's his power?
Caliban can like sense other mutants and like, That's this thing.
Okay, you were telling me about the plot for Wolverine.
Okay, the plot for Wolverine. Everything sucks. He's an Uber driver. He's fucking bummed out all the time. Professor X is deteriorating. He has seizures, which like fucks everything up. They don't have any money. They're just doing their best to survive. They're just treading water. And then Logan is approached by a woman. And she's like, I've got a job for you. I need you to help me. And he's like, I don't want any fucking trouble. I'm not in that business anymore. I don't know what you, I'm not Wolverine. I'm just some fucking guy. I'm just Logan. Leave me the fuck out of your business. And then he also gets approached by Donald Pierce, who is another character from the comic books. He's a cyborg. He was part of the Hellfire Club. But in this, he's a part of the Reavers, which I think Donald Pierce may be a part of the Reavers later on. But originally, he was in the Hellfire Club.
Does that bother you? Does that bother you that they didn't do it accurately to the comic books?
No. I mean, I was fine with Donald Pierce. I didn't have a problem with that. Yeah. So, no, you didn't get me there. You know, I wasn't pissed about Donald Pierce at all. I think you, and I liked the actor, and I liked, I mean, the accent. He was kind of hot. You know, he's evil, but he's kind of hot.
Well, you're pissed about something. I know it.
Well, we'll get to that.
Okay.
So... We, spoilers, we find out that there's a little girl and this little girl needs to make it to this border. They gotta cross over to Canada. She's being hunted by Donald Pierce and his asshole friends, you know, part of this company, evil company. And Logan gets all wrapped up in this nonsense before he knows what's going on, and he is stuck with this little girl who happens to be X-23. We got Laura on the scene. And if you don't know about X-23, she is a clone of Wolverine, and she has a toe claw. So Logan, Professor X, and Laura, they are on a road trip. They are trying to cross the Canadian border within X amount of days, and they're trying to find this place called Eden. And that's the main thing about Logan that's so exciting, is that it is R-rated. It is the first time we've had an R-rated Logan movie.
Woo!
You cannot do a PG-13 Wolverine movie justice. Like, it's just, it's not, he's
sick of PG.
And thank you, Deadpool, you know? Thank you, Deadpool, for that, because if it wasn't for fucking Deadpool, they would not have done this, okay? So, Deadpool, you're the best.
Like, do you think all of the future X-Men movies will be R-rated now?
Well, no, I don't think that the next shitty X-Men movie that they're gonna make is gonna be R-rated, no. I don't believe that.
It was really great to get to see Wolverine poking some folks.
I know, it was so
poked
great.
Poked that guy right in the head.
Oh yeah, it was so great to see him finally letting loose, finally like just slicing and dicing, you know? It's like we've all wanted to see that for so long, and
kinda makes the other Wolverine movies look stupid.
I know, I can't believe it's taken Fox this long to figure it the fuck out. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it ain't rocket science, all right? We wanna see Wolverine cut people's fucking faces open. Like, that's what, he's got claws, that's what he does. In the comic books, Wolverine says very often that he's the best at what he does, but what he does isn't very nice, okay? And so it's great to see him
chopping people's heads off.
Chopping people's heads off in this movie.
What was your favorite part?
Well, my favorite part of the movie is Laura. I really love Laura. I think she was fantastic. I love that actress. She was so great. Even though she doesn't speak through most of the film, she has such great acting with her face, and like her just like murdering dudes left and right was just like so awesome. Like Amy Dallin's described her as a little murder girl, and that's what she is. And what she does isn't very nice, and I loved it.
Did you want to be a little murder girl when you were a little girl?
Well, I mean, I did feel like a mutant, you know, who, like, didn't really have a mutant fam. Like, I had a normal fam. They were, like, not a mutant fam. So it was a little hard for me growing up. So, like, I identified with her because of that, you know? I wanted to see her find her fam, you know? Because that's what it's all about, baby, all right? It's like, if you don't fit in with your family, you know what? You can make your own family, you know? It's the X-Men. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. That's why I love the X-Men. That's why I love the X-Men. And that's why, like, I felt like growing up when I saw that X-Men cartoon, it really flipped a switch in my brain, you know? And I was like, oh my God, you know, I really identify with these characters because I feel really weird. I feel really out of place. I don't feel like everybody else. And the X-Men taught me that it's okay to be different. It's okay to have different abilities than other people. And that you can go find other badasses and then live an awesome mansion together and then like fight the forces of evil and be fucking awesome and wear cool outfits. In fact, like my whole life goal is to become Professor X eventually. I mean, that's where I'm headed. Like if I can get enough money to open my own school for gifted kids and like find them and bring them in and train them to fuck shit up and send them out in the world. Like, let's train people how to really use their brains, you know? Because normal schools don't do that. Like, normal curriculums really don't teach you how to really use your brain. They just teach you how to regurgitate answers to things. Like, oh, listen to this and then just memorize it and say it again. That's not using your brain.
Okay.
So.
I use my brain.
You sure do. Your Intel Pentium processor. This movie talks a lot about masculine fears, a lot of male fears, you know, getting older, disappointing your dad, you know, not being strong enough to protect your child, like being tired, being fucked up from all this fighting you've had to do. But also, it has a slight, tiny allusion to erectile dysfunction.
What? How?
When Wolverine first pops his claws and like one of them like won't come out all the way, you know? And then later on he's like sitting on the bed and he's like, trying to like pull it out, and it was just like, oh god, it was like blood was everywhere, and it was just like brutal. It was super brutal. But that's definitely another masculine fear, you know. This movie encapsulated a lot of masculine fears.
I don't have any masculine fears.
Well, yeah, you're a robot. You're not a man.
I'm all man.
Well, you're a robot who identifies as a man.
I'm the manliest man.
Oh, okay, sure.
That's why I loved Logan.
Right. That's, you know, and I get it. Like I said, I get it, and I'm glad that you guys loved it. And I'm glad for you that you guys loved it, and I'm glad they made a good fucking movie that you guys fucking super dug. And, like, I, even though I don't hate it, you know, I wish I had a little bit more redemption, but I get it.
I liked it when you chopped the face off of that cowboy, mid-cowboy line.
Yeah, that was pretty good. That was, well, a lot of chopping. All the slicing and dicing was great.
You're biased.
Well, it's true. I am biased. I am biased because I love the X-Men, and, like, these are the Fox X-Men. These are not my X-Men. It's, like, not my X-Men, you know? Like, that's me. Hashtag not my X-Men. They're not the true X-Men, okay? They're not the X-Men from the comics. They're not the X-Men that gave me hope as when I was a young mutant, you know? And I just feel like every time Fox puts out an X-Men movie, they just shit the bed, and I just get really frustrated with the whole situation. But this is definitely the best X-Men related movie that they've made. Like, this is definitely the best, but it's still not my true X-Men.
Deadpool was good.
I love Deadpool, and I gave a very favorable review to Deadpool because guess what? Deadpool's wearing his costume. Deadpool is exactly how he is in the fucking comic books. You know, like, he's just...
And Colossus was cool, too.
Colossus was amazing! It's like a Negasonic Teenage Warhead. I mean, they were so great. Like, they were so great, and they were fun! And, like, that's the main thing, is, like, the Deadpool movie, the main thing that I loved about it, even though it's a really goofy movie, yes, there are plot holes. Is it, like, a fucking genius movie? No. But it's fun! It's fun, and it captures the essence of the fun, and it captures the essence of Deadpool and what he's really about and how he really is in the comic books, and really represents him in a way that the X-Men movies have not represented their characters, you know? And in the X-Men movies, it's like, there's just a ban on fun, you know? It's just like, you cannot have fun in any X-Men movie at Fox. Like, you just can't.
Well, don't you think they got Wolverine right?
I don't know if they got him right. They made their own version of him that's a decent version, but it's not necessarily like, it's not like how Ryan Reynolds did Deadpool, you know? I mean, it's not quite right.
All right, are you done bitching?
No.
She needs our help.
Someone will come along.
Someone has come along.
So, even though the Logan movie is definitely the best X-Men-related movie that they've made, even though it is really great on a lot of levels, for me personally, I didn't love the movie because I felt like it was very bleak. And again, it didn't have any of the hope that I'm looking for, and I felt like I was sold a movie that I didn't get. Because I see all of this really awesome marketing with, like, Logan, and he's holding, like, X-23, and he's, like, running with her, and, like, he's protecting this child, you know? And, like, you watch that trailer. That trailer is so amazing, okay? Like, that trailer is so good with the Nine Inch Nails, Johnny Cash song, you know? And it's just, like, it's just what they sold me was that Logan was going to, you know, get involved. And of course he's gonna be apprehensive to get involved with this little girl, but that he was going to accept her, that he was going to protect her, and, like, do his best, you know, and put away his bullshit and his selfishness and be a better man for this little girl. Like, this little girl was gonna inspire hope in him so that he will be the man that he's never been able to be before. Like, he'll finally have a reason to be a better man. And I felt like in this movie, he, at every opportunity, he refuses to be that better man that I was hoping to see from the marketing. You know, I was hoping to see him accept her and say, like, yes, you are my daughter and I want to protect you. And, like, even though this is some bullshit, like, I'm in, like, I'm your dad, like, let's do this. And I just felt like he denied her at every opportunity. And as somebody who grew up with, like, a cold dad, it was just, like, it hurt my feelings for her. I was just like, I know exactly how she felt. And it was just like heartbreaking, you know? And like, the thing is at the end of the movie, Professor X is dead. His car is ruined. Like, he doesn't have any more money. Like, you know, it's like his whole life is like, his whole life is over. I mean, like, everything that he has nothing else. And he's with all of these children, these mutant children who are trying to cross this border. And instead of leading them, and instead of being like the father figure and the leader that he should be, that he could be, like the amazing man that he could be, he decides to sleep in because he's tired and like lets them go on their own and only comes to help them when he sees that they're being attacked and is just like, oh, well, it's not my problem. I'll just let them do this. And it's like, no, like, no, you should have been with those kids. Like, you should have taken responsibility. You should have like been inspired by the fact that Professor X just died and you have to take on his mantle and like take these kids to the border, because what the fuck else do you have to do, Logan? Nothing. There's nothing else. Like, there's nothing else that's more important than this. And you have nothing. And why wouldn't you do this? And that's why, that's like where my main disappointment comes from, is that he never was that guy that I wanted. I didn't feel like he got the redemption, you know? Like, I wanted to see him redeem himself and like be a fucking awesome man. And I felt like I didn't get that. And so I got a little just, you know, I mean, the feels like I wanted it to. But see, at the same time, I do realize that this is my female point of view. You know, I identify more with the female character. And from the male perspective, this movie has a lot more impact. Like, I was talking to some people on Twitter, and they were explaining to me why this movie really hit them in the feels, where I didn't get hit in the feels. And one of the things one of my viewers brought up was that, you know, they are a Marine, you know, they have a daughter, they're a veteran, you know, and how Logan, like, this movie is an amazing metaphor for PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, and like, that's why he can't fight, is because he has PTSD, and like, that's really fucking beautiful, and like, that's really amazing. And they went on to talk about how tired they are and how tired they feel and how they feel like there is this war coming and that they don't know if they have it in them to continue to fight. And I really feel that. And I feel so bad that you guys feel that way. And that you've had to fight, and that it's so awful. It's really upsetting. It's really upsetting, you know? It's like super not okay. I like totally get that, you know? Like, obviously, I super feel that. And I'm like, I just feel so bad that like people have to be put through that, you know? Like, it's just so fucked up, like the world we live in. And like, that's the thing about this movie, is that it represents like how fucked up our world is, you know? And like, and it's like, it's depressing, you know? It's like, I was really depressed after this movie. Like, it really upset me and made me sad, because it's like, is this where we're going? Like, is this what we're doing, guys? Like, is this the world that we're, like, allowing to happen, where, like, these giant corporations just, like, fuck over everybody, and, like, everybody's just been fighting, and they're tired of fighting, and, like, all the mutants have been destroyed, and everyone's gone, and, like, it's like, is that where we're headed, you know? It's like, that's what it feels like, and it fucking sucks, and it super sucks, and, like, you know, when I was growing up and I saw the fucking X-Men cartoon, like, it gave me hope, you know? It's like, the X-Men gave me hope, you know? That was like, I can leave, I can go somewhere, I can find something better for myself, I can use my abilities, you know, even though other people don't understand them, in ways that help the world, and I can find other people that are like me, and we can, like, work on this shit together, you know? But, like, in this movie, like, all, like, the dream is dead. Like, they failed. Like, the X-Men failed. And, like, so did fucking Professor X, you know? And it's, and he's just a problem, you know? It's just, like, Professor X just becomes a problem. And it's just upsetting to, it's just, like, it's just depressing to me. And I'm just, I just, like, if, like, I think of, like, myself, if I was a young girl and I was watching this movie, like, watching these movies now, like, I just want to, like, slip my wrists and give up, you know? Like, it wouldn't give me hope to, like, keep fighting and to, like, find my family and to, like, learn about my powers and how to utilize them, you know? It's just, like, fucked up. Like, it's super fucked up. And, I mean, I don't know. Like, I think that, and I see why a lot of guys like this movie, because it's very, it's a lot more, it's a lot about realism and about what's really going on. And I get that, and I think that's, I mean, I get it. I totally obviously get it, but I just want to, I want to inspire, like, I want to be inspired, you know, and this makes me also just tired. Like, that's the thing that I hated about this movie is that I already feel really tired because I feel like I've been, like, personally fighting to, like, keep my business afloat so I can do this, so that I can talk to you guys about art and I can teach people about it because, like, no one's defending the arts, you know? Like, and it made me want to give up and just say, like, why am I even doing this? You know, like, maybe I should just give up, you know, because, like, it all sucks. And while I can appreciate this movie and the reality that it presented, I feel like the essence and the core of the X-Men is, like, we can make a better world, you know? Like, we can work together and we can make a better world and, like, make it to where we can all live together in fucking peace, like, mutants and humans alike, you know? And that's not what's presented in this. And so, you know, that's where I get upset. You know, that's my problem. That's my hang-up. Because this movie is, like, the worst-case scenario for the X-Men, you know? I mean, it's just, Professor X is hurting people and should probably be put out of his misery because it's like he's so powerful and if he has seizures, like, he can just fuck people up really hard, you know? And, like, his dream is dead and the X-Men are dead. And we never find out, did Professor X kill the X-Men accidentally? Like, is that the deal that's going on? I mean, that was really vague and that kind of annoyed me as well, where it's like, what happened? Like, what happened? And we never find out, and they just kind of make these very vague allusions to it, and it's really depressing to me to think that, like, potentially Professor X killed everybody. You know, it's one of my mutant powers. I have a lot of feels, you know? So, it's like, I feel it. Like, I get it, guys. I get it. I get it. But I just want to build a better world. Like, I think that we can, but maybe I'm an idealist, and maybe I'm a fool, you know? I don't know. You know, and a lot of people tell me I'm an idealist and I'm an elitist, but, like, I think that we can reach higher and we can do better if we just work together. Like, I think that it's possible. I know that it's possible. I know that it's possible, but trying to get people to work together is just, like, human beings are just chaos fucking assholes, and, like, it's like herding cats, you know? We just cannot seem to work together, and I just don't get it, and we just harm one another, and we fuck each other over, and it just makes me sick, and it's upsetting, and it's unnecessary, and I feel like a lot of this is unnecessary, and I just want to go to that Star Trek future, you know, like, you know what, fuck this Professor X shit, I want to go to the Picard, like, let's go to, like, Star Trek Next Generation Picard, you know, Patrick Stewart, you know, I'll just hang out with him, hang out with that dude, that's where I want to be, that's, it's totally possible.
Oh, you didn't even talk about Professor X. What do you think of his character?
I mean, I love Patrick Stewart. I love Patrick Stewart a lot. I have a lot of love in my heart for him. And yeah, I mean, I was just he was good. Like, he's always good. He's always amazing in whatever he does. He always gives 110%. And I thought he did a great job, and he was, like, his performance was very, very touching, you know? And it also touched on getting old and, like, how scary it is, you know? And, like, dying and, like, all these things that are, like mortality, you know? It's just, like, really fucked up. And, like, being a dad who's, like, a burden, you know? Like, being an old dude who's just, like, a burden on everybody and, like, all this stuff. Like, I get it. I felt like, too, with his character, like, the way he died, I was upset with, like, the way he was just, like, unceremoniously killed, and that was upsetting to me. Well, it's just depressing, you know? It's just everything was depressing, and everything, like, took away hope, you know? It's like at every turn, you know, like they go to the farm and they have this really nice dinner. And he was like, this is the best night like that I've had in like so long. And then he's just murdered. And then the whole family's murdered. And it just sucks. It's like, maybe the mutants should die because all they do is like get people hurt. And I hated seeing the family get hurt, you know, the farmers. It was just like, that's the whole thing. It just sucked. It's just depressing. It's really depressing. And I wanted something that was like I said, I just wanted to see Logan be a better man. And like, rise above, you know, and get past the depressing shit. But like, that's all Fox wants to do. And like, that's, and I, okay, I guess that's the X-Men now. It's just depressing. Hated it. I mean, it's good. It is good. I mean, the thing is, it's well made. Like, I mean, it is, there's a lot of things that are great about it, you know, but it's just like not the message that I think that's needed right now. And it's not the essence of, you know, what the X-Men taught me. And you know, it's just, I got a lot of weird personal attachments mixed up in this. So, you know, it's like, I'm not your average viewer. Average people are gonna love it, you know? I mean, my sister loved it. So many people I know loved it. And they were like, oh, you're gonna love it so much. And then everyone was so disappointed, you know, when I was like, didn't love it. Yeah, and like, even the metaphor of like, he has to like, you know, Wolverine has his younger self that he's gotta like, kill or whatever, and he's just like this berserker. I don't know, I didn't like that very much either. I mean, I don't have a better suggestion, but
why?
I just didn't connect with it, you know. It's like, it was just depressing. Like, it was just more depressing shit, you know. It's like somebody took your genes and then made you again and then made you an asshole, and then you got to fight your asshole self. But it wasn't like in a really smart, intelligent way where it's like he's fighting his shadow self, you know, and there was no real resolution. He didn't help his self. His self just had to get shot in the head and killed. There was no helping that guy. He just had to be murdered because he was just a problem. Like every mutant's a problem, you know? It's fucking depressing.
All right, tell me about the Old Man Logan comic.
Well, if you didn't know, this movie is very slightly, tinily based on this comic in particular, Old Man Logan. It's a standalone comic. It's in its own universe. It's its own whole thing. It was kind of like a one-off kind of series. It's written by Mark Millar. Yeah, this is relatively recent. This came out about 8 years ago in 2009. And in this comic, it's also set, you know, like 50 years in the future or so, and Logan is an old man. But in this comic, all of the heroes, like, there was this huge event where all of the bad guys got together and they killed like all of the heroes, and there's no more superheroes, mutants are not being born anymore, and the United States has been divvied up between all of the main like supervillains. Like, Red Skull has his area. The Hulks, like, have their whole area. Doctor Doom has his whole area. Like, the Kingpin has an area. Like, everybody's got an area. And it's very post-apocalyptic, super post-apocalyptic. But in this, it is also a road trip comic. You have Hawkeye, actually, and he's still around, and he comes to Logan. And Logan now is a simple farmer. He hasn't popped his claws in 50 years. He has a wife and two kids. And he is behind on his rent. You know, these giant, the Hulks, like, that own the land, like, they haven't paid their rent in, like, a month or something.
Wait, Hulks own the land?
Yeah, the Hulk banner was given, like, California and kind of the West Coast. And apparently he bred with his cousin Jennifer, who's She-Hulk, I assume against her will, and now has propagated an entire inbred family of Hulks called Greennecks, and they're just like inbred Hulks that are like crazy. Yeah. This comic is super out there, by the way. Like, I mean, they're not, like, Fox would never do anything that's like They'll take the road trip aspect. They'll take the 50 years in the future, you know. They'll take that, but they're not going to do this comic, like, ever.
Okay, is that good or bad?
Well, I mean, I don't know. I think it's a great comic, and I think that not every comic book needs to be turned into a movie, and you should just read this fucking comic book, because it's really great. So you should totally check this out. If you liked Logan, and you want to kind of see where it came from, I think this is definitely something you should check out. That's totally worth your read. I mean, I read it. You can read it in a night. It's not really long. It's not a big deal.
Doesn't he fight the Incredible Hulk?
He does fight Bruce Banner. He does fight Bruce Banner in the end. And Bruce Banner's, like, super old. And, like, he's super strong, though. He's, like, kicking his ass. And then eventually, like, Logan, you know, finally makes him angry eventually. And then he's like, oh, no, you know, you just made me angry. And he turns, like, super angry old Hulk. And then you just see this panel. The fight ends with, like, the Hulk just, like, eating Wolverine. So, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's super nuts. It's, like, super crazy. But not before Wolverine, like, kills the entire Hulk clan. So, like, he kills, like, all of them. So, it's, like...
Well, that sounds dark and disturbing.
Yeah, I mean, it's very... It's Mark Millar. So, it's gonna be, like, that writer in particular, he writes very kind of a little bit darker, a little bit weirder, a little bit grosser stories. So, this kind of... It's a write-up. If you're into Mark Millar, you know, same kind of stuff, same old song, you know what I'm saying? But I had a lot of fun reading this, and I think you should definitely check it out. It's totally worth a read, you know, if you want to get into comics. And like I said, you don't have to, like, know anything about any other continuities. You don't have to have read anything else. You can just dive into this. It's a contained series. It's all in this one book. So you can just pick it up and read it and be done with it. There's no other things you have to go read afterwards. It's, like, totally chill. So it's a really great graphic novel. For those of you who want to read a Wolverine story, but you don't want to get into the whole monthly situation, where do you start, and, like, all that shit's a whole lot of crap to deal with. It's a whole bag of cats. This is just one cat versus a whole bag of cats.
Okay, got it.
So, yeah. Yeah.
Very good.
Hey, everybody. I'm so excited to announce that this spring-summer quarter... I am starting a Dune book club where we are going to be talking live once a week about the book Dune. We're going to read it together. We're going to talk about it. I am so fucking excited about it. And we are also going to be selling a little something I call the Comic Book Girl 19 Dune Box. Where?
Dune Box?
Yeah, the Dune Box, okay?
Is that like one of those dork boxes?
Yeah, it's like a geek crate, whatever the fuck, you know, kind of thing. But in it...
You have your own dork box?
I have a dork box, yeah. It's pretty awesome, though, because it's Dune related, okay? And what is going to come in this box is you're going to get a paperback version of the book. I'm going to sign that book. You will also be receiving a bookmark, a special Comic Book Girl 19 Dune bookmark. There will also be some pins. You know how pins are a hot thing right now. I'm going to design some Dune pins, so you're going to get some special Dune pins in there, like a Chris knife and some shit. It's going to be awesome. And maybe some other goodies. We're still, like, working out all the details. There'll be more information coming out soon as we get things designed. I'll be releasing our designs, letting you know what exactly everything's going to look like in the box. There might even be a little teeny bottle of spice melange, if I can make that happen. That's, like, something I really want to make happen, so...
Wow.
Yeah, so it's gonna be... I gotta talk to my friends on Arrakis and see if I can get a deal. You know, we're working it out, so it's gonna be a lot of fun. That'll be going on sale. We're gonna be doing a pre-sale for that pretty soon in the next couple weeks, so we'll let you know more details as we go along. But, yeah, I mean, I'm really fucking stoked to do a Dune... book club with you guys this summer. And the Dune box, like, the reason we're selling this is to help fund the show. So it's gonna help fund the weekly Dune show and everything else that we do here and all the reviews, because guess what guys, this year I'm not working for the man this year, okay? I'm just gonna work for you guys, because I'm, like, kind of done working for the man, okay? You know what I want to do? I want to work for you. I want to work for my patrons.
Did you work for the man before?
Yeah, I did a little bit, and I'm not doing that.
It didn't work out?
You know, I can't really talk about it without getting potentially sued by somebody, so I'm not going to say anything, but what I am going to tell you is that I want to work for you guys, and I want to do fun stuff with you guys this year, and I want to put a lot more time and effort into our YouTube and our live shows, and we're going to be expanding our operations, doing a lot of new stuff this year. I'm really excited about it. And I just want to commit myself to our channel, you know, because I'm tired of getting caught up in trying to help other people's shitty platforms. So, you know, I just want to work on my shitty platform. So,
where do I go and when do I go?
Okay, so the details will be released soon. Be on the lookout. Follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, follow me on Facebook. Keep watching my videos, and you will find out all the information as it becomes available. It's still coming together right now, but we'll be doing a pre-sale in the next couple weeks. Probably at the beginning of April, there'll be a pre-sale going on. So we'll definitely let you know when that goes down. I really... like, it's gonna be fun. Like, I'm really excited about designing these pins. Like, I'm really good stuff.
Want some of that spice?